Hare Krishna. Time can be a fire in which we burn or a teacher from whom we learn. Time is an extremely powerful force. It's subtle, but it's irresistible. With every passing moment, we are being pushed inexorably towards bodily destruction, towards death. And even by spending millions of dollars, we cannot get one moment back. So time can be a fire in which everything that we have worked on for in life can be destroyed. This is a fire incinerates everything. Similarly, all our achievements, all our possessions, they all can be destroyed in one moment. And this vision of time as a all-devouring fire is given in the Bhagavad-Gita in the 11th chapter when Krishna displays his Vishwarupa, his universal form, and within that he displays his Kalarupa. Kalarupa is his form as time. So as time, there's a huge fire coming from his mouth and all the worlds are being destroyed by that fire. And Arjun, when he asks, he gets alarmed on seeing this fiery, scary form of the divine that is manifested before him. And he asks, who are you? In 11.13, Akhya hime ko bhavanugra rupo. He asks, who are you? And 11.32, Krishna replies saying that, kalosmi loka kshaykrut pravriddho. Lokan samahartum iha pravritta rute pitvamna bhavishyanti sarve. He says that, O Arjun, I am time. I am the destroyer of all the worlds. Lokakshaya krut pravriddho. And I have come here to destroy everyone except rute pitvam na bhavishyanti sarve. Except for you, O Pandavas, everybody will be destroyed over here. So what is Krishna telling over here? That those who do not surrender to him, those who dare to defy him, for them, Krishna as time will be a fire in which they will all burn. They will all be destroyed. But for Arjun, who has surrendered to Krishna just before the Bhagavad Gita, he has surrendered to Krishna and has inquired from him about what is the way to live. So for him, Krishna, that same time is manifested as Krishna. And Krishna is a teacher from whom he learns. And similarly for us, time can also be either a fire or a teacher. Now for us, time may not manifest either in a graphic form of fire nor in the form of Krishna himself. But we also have a choice. If we stay attached to the temporary thing, material things of the world, then time will act as a fire and will destroy everything that we are attached to. But when we see things deteriorating, we see things destroying, getting destroyed, we see people who were once captivatingly attractive, they become jaded, their face becomes shriveled, their beauty disappears. When we see powerful athletes, powerful boxers getting paralyzed, when we see heads of state getting brain degenerative diseases and not even remembering who they were. In such situations, we can understand that time will destroy everything temporary, and therefore we need to focus our energy on connecting with the eternal, on devoting ourselves to the eternal, on directing our hearts toward the supreme eternal reality, Krishna. So if we see times inexorable destructiveness as a teacher, oh, let me not be attached to the temporary because it will be destroyed. Let me direct our heart towards the eternal, towards the supreme eternal divinity Krishna. Then time can become a powerful teacher which helps us to break free from the attachments that shackle us and which helps us to nourish and strengthen the divine attachment that will liberate us. So by studying the Bhagavad Gita and understanding the nature of time, and by living the Bhagavad Gita, by striving to devote ourselves to Krishna, we'll find that time will become a teacher. Time will be Krishna himself who will take us to Krishna for a life of eternal joy with him. Thank you. Hare Krishna.